NGPA got its start officially in 1990. I had met Tim Sullivan in 1989 and laid some groundwork and got ideas, but we were officially underway with our P.O. Box and our Annie Advocate. I mean, the whole purpose was just meeting quality people and networking.
Hi, I'm Rob Neighbor. I've been a member of NGPA since 1989, when there were only a handful of us in the organization. Brian Samuelson, the co-founder of NGPA, called me up and he says, "We're going to have our first event down in Key West, Florida. You got to come." I went down there and had a ball. And you know, we didn't know each other's last names, no phone numbers, no airline IDs. All we knew was that we were gay pilots and we weren't alone. And that lesson, I swear, is the most important one that you can take from any NGPA event. But the friendships I've formed and the people out there from all walks of life, from all different airlines that have my back, make this organization absolutely invaluable to me. And I love being a 25-year member of the NGPA. Thanks for those great times.
We were all basically terrified that our jobs and careers were going to be come to an end if someone found out. Early 90s, you could still be denied a security clearance for being gay. I mean, the homophobia was not only tolerated, it was okay, it was sporting. The good old boy network, in quotes.
I would say the most significant event that I've been to was the day I joined NGPA back in 1993, and it was the March on Washington. I felt I was the only gay pilot out there. And to come into a room full of gay pilots that were very welcoming was an incredible experience.
You know, in every ad, we wrote newsletters, personals, events, totally discreet. And our first 2 years, we tried to just stay under the radar. We're just trying to make it safe so someone could possibly think about joining. Maybe a private pilot who's tortured at his local FBO know that, you know, you are not the only one. There are others out there. There were four of us trying to figure out, get this thing going, and we knew HIV was an issue. And he called the FAA up, and they were like, "Whoa, what do you mean? There aren't any gay pilots." It's like, and he just said, very deadpan, I said, "Well, I believe there might be, but that's not the issue. We have HIV, and you're the medical. How do we address that?" And so, but we help pilots with those needs network. And to this day, you know, 15 years later, you know, 20 years later, and they keep their licenses and their careers and their health. And that was so important at the time. We were mainstreaming the word gay and pilot. And the FAA thought, well, no such thing, right? So important about taking on Hachette Filippacci magazine, who did own Flying magazine, and taking on Trade-A-Plane in Crossville, Tennessee. We ran an ad, initially turned down our ad, and then we resubmitted our ad from California. And the California law says, okay, you don't have to do business with us, but you cannot do business in the entire state of California. And these are the laws, and so Trade-A-Plane had a choice, either accept our ad or drop all its subscribers in California. I think the legal department became more and more aware of just what you can't do to others. I credit Stephen Moore for actively calling them up in recent years, talking to their HR departments and trying to, you know, hey, we're here and you got to pay attention to us, and HR departments were aware of that.
I would have to say that I owe my whole aviation professional career to the NGPA and the people that I met through it. Back in 2007, Greg Zunkowitz helped me get my Pilatus job. And then in 2011, James Duvier helped me get my GoJet job. So I'm very thankful for all the help that I've received professionally through the NGPA and all the amazing people I met.
I say, hey, we should do a scholarship program. I say, hey, we can do that too. We got that up and running. We're just helping people to this day. You know, I talked to Dave Pettit, and so, yeah, I've personally benefited from being a member, and so I'm selfishly very gratified to see that we've not just helped ourselves, we help future generations and beyond that.
Hello, my name is Aaron Reck. I am a member of the National Gay Pilots Association and joined the NGPA, I want to say about 2002 when I was a student pilot. I came home from my first flying lesson very excited about the whole experience, and I Googled lesbian pilot and up popped the NGPA website, and I've been really thankful for its presence and its people ever since.
Rob Neighbor designed our logo, and he was one of our early on members, and we were asking for a $20 minimum donation to get going, and I remember he was about member 30, give or take. And he had sent us about $35. Like, wow, someone sent us extra money? You got those letters of inspiration that kept you going. And then we also get the other letters in the P.O. box. Tim Sullivan would call me up. I said, we got another one. I was like, what? A letter like Rob Neighbors? He's like, no, we got another death threat. Oh, and usually they were religious and gun-based and how they want, what they wanted to do to us and how they wanted to kill us. So that was also motivation to stay under the radar. Safety in numbers. And we grew with them.
I've been very active with NGPA. It means a lot to me, and I'll tell you why. My partner Tim and I have met more friends and more people at NGPA we never would have met. People with common interests such as airplanes and flying.
The most talented pilots in this association are not the gentlemen and ladies that fly the 747s. The gentlemen and ladies that are the private pilots that have other businesses and jobs and talents. Bill McGowan, who was a printer by trade, said, oh, I'm just a private pilot. So, are you kidding me? You're a printer. That's awesome. Do you think you could help us out? And I said, yeah, of course. And he brought us into the, out of the dark ages with our newsletter. And, the private pilots have always done heavy lifting in this association. And I'm eternally grateful for it. So our first nationally advertised event was in Provincetown, 1991. We were living up to our promise of newsletter events and totally discreet. We didn't know who was going to go. We didn't have phone number or voicemail. In Provincetown on a Friday and wear basically a T-shirt with an airplane or something identifying yourself as a pilot. And so I was there at 7 promptly. And you just see the people trickle in like, oh, that guy has his EAA shirt on. You know, and people were with great trepidation walked in the door. And about 35 of us, and by the end of the evening, we're all fast friends, but people shared the same common war stories of homophobia, and, you know, they came up here very cautiously thinking, is this a trap from the FAA, or are they going to be exposed or fired? And, I mean, a military pilot wouldn't come within 1,000 miles of us, and a couple of airline guys securing themselves and their careers cautiously so. It worked out fantastically. And basically from then on, Gay Pilots Association was born. And then we eventually morphed it into the National Gay Pilots Association. You know, the scholarship, the taking on Trade a Plane, the political activism, the taking on Flying Magazine, the taking on of AOPA, they were pretty friendly about it at the time. They rolled over very easily. All right. But we still have homophobia. We still have ALPA, future issues to take on.
It's going to be a great year, and we can all be proud of the past accomplishments we've achieved and the upcoming goals which we'll continue to set and make stride toward meeting. By continuing to work together, we can celebrate not only 25 years of history of diversity and inclusion in aviation, but also make possible another 25 years ahead and beyond. Just think, for a quarter of a century, we have grown from a few guys meeting to have dinner and drinks on a random weekend in P-Town. To this. And the sky is truly the limit for this group. I'm so grateful to be a part of it. Thank you.
Don't stop me, 'cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky.